Philippine government finally greenlights the dry run of limited face-to-face classes more than a year since the pandemic forced school closures. The Education Department says around 120 public and private schools in areas considered low risk for COVID-19 will participate in the pilot test. Students will report to school every other week for half-day or 3 to 4 hour classes.
Kailangan numero uno papasa sa safety assessment ng Department of Education ang lugar kung saan tayo mag-hold ng face-to-face classes. Pangalawa, kailangan pumayag ang local governments dahil sila ang mag-host ng mga pilot classes na ito. Pangatlo, kailangan may written consent ng mga parents na papayag sila na yung kanilang anak ay sasali sa pilot classes. Pang-apat, ang sinabi namin, ang facilities ng Department of Education kailangang handa para sa requirements of the IATF and the Department of Health. Sa kindergarten, sa klase, 12 ka-learners. Sa grade 1 to 3, 16 ka-learners para magkaroon tayo ng space for distancing. And saka sa technical vocational students, pwedeng up to 20 learners.
The DepEd adds, vaccination will not be a requirement for participating teachers.
Ang sabi nga niya na kung mga teachers natin, mga staff na 65 years old and below, kung walang comorbidities, pwede silang sumali sa programa, pwede silang mag-serve regardless of their vaccination status.
Some teachers groups have welcomed this latest development, but for the Teachers Dignity Coalition, the conduct of in-person classes is untimely and risky as the government has not improved its COVID response.
The Philippines logged nearly 19,000 new COVID cases Monday, the lowest in 5 days. But the health department says the country has yet to see a peak in infections, especially as the Delta COVID variant becomes the dominant strain in the country. Over 300 additional cases of the more contagious variant have been detected by the Philippine Genome Center, raising the total to 3,027. It has already surpassed the percentage of alpha and beta variant carriers, which fueled a surge in infections earlier in the year.
Bataan is set to be placed under the strictest lockdown classification as it deals with its first ever community transmission of COVID-19. The province will go under enhanced community quarantine for 2 weeks or until October 4. The provincial government has also canceled all inbound passenger flights until further notice. That's as quarantine and isolation facilities in the province reach full capacity. Bataan has recorded 100 new COVID infections Monday, pushing its total case count to 138.